Madam?
Yes, madam.
I think we can start with the session.
Yeah, sure. Slowly we can
yes, ma'am,
have a
yes,
conversation.
Ma'am.
Yes.
Thank you so much, ma'am.
Yeah, thank you, ma'am. Yeah, good afternoon, everyone. Welcome you all to the day, the last day session of STTP4. I am with you all. Most of you are sailing with the team from the STTP1 to till now. Now I will just erase this all because the session started. I wanted to, as usual, start with one small question. How many of you have deployed any one small model deployment, either with the browser locally or with the cloud? So once after building machine learning or deep learning, or more or less all the concepts will become same when it becomes a deployment perspective. Yes, we have training phase, testing phase, we have the coding, we have sample input, then for the given input it needs to work and it should give the results back. So all together, I would like to know from the comment section how many of you have deployed, at least for the academic perspective or academic point of view, one model into the cloud or into the web server, either one, cloud or into the web server. I am just looking at the chat window. If you have that kind of experience, you please comment in the chat window. Yeah, no, fine, yeah. Any answer is going to come with audio? Okay, then I mute. Once at the last stage, I'll give you the access for speaking. I mute right now all. Yeah, that's fine. Anyone, one more time I repeat the question. Anybody joined newly also, please give your comment. Experience of deploying the model. We the academician, we do all off shelf, offline. I mean, it's a batch process. We will take out the data, pull out, and we will do several models, and we do improvement or we do anything. But then finally, we publishize the paper. Then whatever the kind of experience we have gathered across that project or research walkthrough, we'll be sharing with either one of the forum, either in the classroom or like kind of keynote speaker or invited speaker like this, you will be doing. That's fine. Now, whether you have gotten experience in deploying the model, because when it comes business point of view or application point of view, this is the ultimate or end result. So that's the reason I'm asking whether you have gotten experience, yes or no. One answer I have got. Thank you for your answer. How about others? Any few, if you have experience, you please submit it. I will hold for a minute. So 3-4 answers I have got. That gives a good fair idea, because I wanted to know. I'm just giving today's session for the beginners level, so it's kind of academic project, not even the real-time deployment, but this is the first step towards any kind of model deployment. That is the reason. So what level I can start, the scratch level or intermediate level, that is a fair idea I wanted to have. Okay, now today we are going to look at a platform called Heroku. Heroku is a platform we are going to discuss in order to deploy the model. It's a cloud-based platform. So you would have heard this name, but you would have not worked, because since you say I haven't done the deployment model, you would have heard. So let us understand what is all about this Heroku. It's a dyno. Dyno is a technical word. Here in Heroku cloud platform, they are using that word. So terminology may differ from cloud platform to cloud platform, or may be common, I'm not sure. So this dyno is a virtual run instance. The moment we deploy our app, any kind of web application or mobile application, if we deploy into this platform Heroku, then it will create one dyno, one instance. So using that instance, the request can go for that app. So this dyno for the free account holders, it that is the beauty. That is the reason I'm demonstrating. Or else no, for this workshop, I may need to spend some dollars. I need to show you the demo. I'm not that. So this is free academic demonstrative purposes, or even real-time purposes also. You can move forward with the Dino. This Dino will create one virtual instance. Only one Dino is permitted per user for free account. So you will come to know, by this time you would have got to know what is Dino, I mean to say. Virtual instance, that's it. So it will permit only one Dino per user. That allows 600 requests at a time. So that is called website scalability. YouTube, Gmail, Facebook, WhatsApp, just you imagine the scalability, massive scale. 1,000 together, lakhs together, millions, billions together, people are accessing. So in order to reduce that only, people have come out with a Google. If you look at google.in, google.us, google.uk, then domains is labeled based on the geographical domain. That IN stands for India. So that then they thought of. Even then they have brought out India itself. We just imagine right this moment how many are hitting YouTube, either in the form of uploading or downloading or watching or viewing or just clicking. All those kinds of that request, if we calculate, that is massive scale. So the moment we want to become web developer, we need to look at what is a scalability it is providing. How many instances it is permitted to create for a single coding, for a single application, how many instances it is possible to create. Per instance, how many requests. So these are all few groundwork we may need to do. That absolutely comes into web technology or cloud services. This all kind of matter. By the time you can explore. So with this small note, I'll move on. So this Heroku platform is useful for creating add-ons, creating databases, any particular services we can create a database. This Heroku platform uses Postgres database. We know Informix, DB3, MySQL, SQL Server, so many Oracle, so many DB. We know InfluxDB. So many DBs are available, MongoDB, etc., etc. So among all those DB, Postgres is for SQL, Structured Query Language. This is the DB it supports. So then it uses add-ons. It provides a lot of app promotion and data, many more. You can go through marketplace of this Heroku, what and all we can explore, what are all the apps are released here. So we'll come to know a lot, many more apps for free of cost. We can make use of those services also. So even if you want to run a small business, we can make use of this Heroku. Suppose you want to create one small app, small website for your own profile building. Many of my friends, they have their website. They will bring their resume. That's it. So what about themselves, their picture, contact details, and all their social media information. Subsequently, their research profile and experience, etc., etc. The complete resume about their biography, they will bring. So such kind of thing, we can definitely make use of this. Now, this is what the introduction about Heroku. Creating an account. I'm using my student account. So today I'm going to walk through exclusively his own mini project. So what is a mini project he have done, Manideep? So that mini project only I'm going to walk through today. Student credential, it allows Heroku account for free. And another advantage of Heroku is we can bring the code, deploy our code either directly, or we can create a repository into GitHub. GitHub repository, we can bring here and deploy. We can bring a model. Deployment, finally, our application should be deployed into server or cloud. There is a subtle difference between web server and web cloud. So it either one we need to bring. Only then anywhere, anyone can access it. For example, right now, we are accessing this Zoom through cloud. Zoom is tied up with Oracle Cloud. Oracle Cloud services only supporting Zoom. YouTube has their own cloud. Google have brought a lot of infrastructure centers. So their cloud services are functioning for this whole accessibility. Now, Heroku supports students learning with a cloud-based platform. So these are all the two, GitHub students and only purely students. So there are two different links we can operate. So first we need to create an account with Heroku. Another step is we need to create an account with GitHub in order to do this project. Even if I release the code, even if I give all the details stuff to you, you must create account with Heroku and GitHub. So that is the very first step. Then first half an hour, we walk through the theory or 40 minutes. Subsequently, we will go for hands-on session. A simple spam detection. Given the mail, body of the mail, the project which we are going to discuss is, by looking at the body of the text or message, it needs to be classified into spam or not, or ham or not. Even Gmail is doing that. Every mail, the moment it arrives our account, it categorizes into first two steps only, spam or not a spam only, it will classify. If it is not a spam only, it will take further classification, four types of classification: inbox, promotion, social, update. So about this detailed we discussed in the previous HTTPs. So this is the way Gmail functions. This is one of the famous problem statement. Anyone, if you claim that we are machine learning, deep learning enthusiast, we must show this kind of projects. There are famous top 10 projects are available. So that projects everyone must do and demonstrate. Slightly we need to modify, then we need to show that this is how I groomed myself. These are all my projects showcase. Even this message you can convey to your students also. So now we are coming to Heroku is a cloud platform as a service. It is a platform as a service. We know cloud is infrastructure as a service, platform as a service, application as a service. These are all, there are several more services have come even now. So these are all the services provided by cloud. So here, what is the meaning of platform as a service? We don't own any operating system. We don't do any virtualization of that operating system. We don't create any instances. Everything will be taken care by that platform. So we need to understand a very few steps. With that steps, it is easy for us to deploy the model. If we ourselves buying the server, even a small server, imagine you want to convert your own laptop as a server, then it requires a lot of steps to deploy. First, set up the server operating system, partitioning, so many things we need to do, customizing, and all those settings we need to do. Only then we can keep working with any kind of applications or any kind of deployment. Whereas when we are preferring platform as a service, all those efforts are reduced. That's the reason people are going behind of platforms. Now you may ask question, Oracle platform, Google platform, AWS, Azure, these are all free. Even AWS gives a free cloud space for students community. Even those who are all enrolling as a AWS Educate. So Educate means educating professionals. We can become trainer. So it is giving free of cost. That's fine. So if we have such kind of account only, we can make use of AWS. Otherwise, it is not possible for a very common public or common layman. Whereas Heroku permits for that, but you may need to give your student credential. So either your student credential or you need to give your account as a, in the form of student. So these are all the tricks we can make use of it. What's the difference is, these are all the platform, Azure, whatever I said, these are all for medium and large scale, extra large scale. So exascale. So these kind of offers only that is meant for. Whereas this Heroku is small scale and medium scale. The limitation capacity is up to medium scale. So here this Heroku also provides pay per use or licensed, all those facilities like enterprise edition, everything is available. For free of cost, it allows one dyno, one instance. So that is the only difference. So initially 2007, and I can say that Heroku is one of the first cloud platform. So very early stage even than AWS. It supported only Ruby programming language. Now it supports Java, Node.js, Scala, Clojure, Python, PHP, Go. These are all the language. Now Go is the need of the hour. The moment anyone starts learning Go, immediately the package is 12 lakhs per annum. Minimum starts with 8 lakhs per annum, Go. So this is need of the hour, Go and Shift, one more language. I may not type here, Shift is another language. So these two are nowadays the hiring process is more. Heroku is said to be polyglot platform. So what is the meaning is, it will run and scale applications in ASM across most languages. So we can, it supports for many languages, that is the meaning. Next, it is container-based cloud platform. First we mean, and the platform as a service. So these two related to cloud services or cloud platform. The moment we step into cloud, they used to call container-based cloud platform. So what that container is, it is a standard unit of software that packs up code and all its dependencies so that the quick and reliability of computation is improved. That is a main definition, we can say. It is a host OS. It creates several guest OS operating systems. Then it fences the resources. So it will provide a room, a reservoir for that request for one dyno. So as long as that guest stays in that, it will give that resource. The moment they leave, they kill that operation or they stop that dyno, then immediately that will be relinquished and it will be given to any other services are made available to be free. So now VMware is one of the best example for this container based VMware. We can install for our laptop also. So whenever we install two different operating system, we need to partition Linux and Windows. The moment we bring VMware, big data or any other Hadoop applications, you can start executing with the flavor of Unix. That VMware will launch. The moment you launch the VMware only, Unix operating system is brought in our machine. If we are installing two different operating system, that is dual booting will happen. During the booting itself, it will ask us whether you want to mount with Linux or you would like to mount with Windows operating system. So that is where that mounting will happen. Whereas VMware will give us the freedom, only one operating system. The owner of that machine is only one operating system, but with the VMware, we can launch yet another operating system, we can switch over. So that is one best example for container-based application. Finally, containerization is defined as the form of operating system virtualization. What is virtualization? Is the same operating system. It permits several services to access. So that is what virtualization. Application or run in isolated user space. So it will run in isolated user spaces. That's all. It's a shared operating system, we can say. So this is the main strength or core strength of Heroku. Next, cloud platform as a service. Essential OS and all other supporting softwares enabled platform. So this, whatever we say, platform as a service, all the necessary running softwares, supporting system software, I can say, operating system, all other supporting system softwares are provided, enabled. For example, the definition itself we can understand. In 2007, Heroku started only with Ruby language. Now it supports all the language. What that signifies is this platform has the necessary system software or compiler or interpreter or virtual machines. If it is Java, virtual machine. So these all are bundled into that platform. Then upon the request, operating system, all the software services together will be handed over to that request. So that is the meaning. Now, storage and what is the meaning? Cloud platform, server, storage, networking. These all are three things. Network in the sense web services or network, internet, WWW. All these three steps are owned by third party provider. So we the developer will make use of that with minimal level of understanding the commands. That is what I'm telling. Converting any one fresh server installing with the necessary operating system. You may prefer Linux or Unix platform or Windows platform or Mac OS or any kind of operating system or CentOS, any kind of operating system you may prefer. CentOS as well as there are several other variants of CentOS is also available. So what you prefer, you need to first install, you need to create a lot of kernels, lot of layers. After that, you need to go for virtualization concept. All those things, starting from the scratch of operating system, a raw operating system too, you need to enable it as a web server. That web logic, all those things we need to bring. When it becomes this kind of cloud platform services, there is no headache. Now, this is absolute platform for free. If you wish to explore a lot on Heroku, for a small website launching, hosting, actually, especially this particular project to whom I am referring, that student during this lockdown developed 3 to 4 projects, websites along with their teams, team of students. They earned around 1 lakh. Then they divided each other of 25,000 each one. So they started deploying. By the time they prefer this Heroku, so that a Heroku platform, we can rely on to any platform because they work for only small scale, a local e-commerce website, a local business vendors who operate only within Hyderabad or their known circle. So that they used. If you want to know more, there is a free course available in Udacity. So this course you can undergo, you will come to know much more. Now, this is only for deployment. We will keep our code into this platform so that we will get one URL. That URL can be provided to anyone in our brochure or business promotion. Anyone clicks that, they could be able to see the services or applications. This is only that much. Next, we need to convert our Python code into web development framework. Only then we can deploy a raw code which is suitable only for our machine, either Spider notebook, Jupyter notebook, anything which we use, or PyCharm. Or the best way to always work is with .py, Anaconda execution with .py. Only then we will come to know all the dependencies, all the necessary installments. We know default installments, whereas Jupyter, this all we use, no? It will have some initial setups and installations. We will not be aware what are all the dependencies requirements we require. Whenever we are deploying to the Heroku platform, we need to mention requirements.txt file. All the necessary dependencies, packages, all the necessary installments, we need to instruct in a file to the Heroku platform. By the time, we will not be aware of what is there in our machine, by default it is provided, what we have installed, what is as a whole it is required for deployments or executing this code in the subsequent requirement. None of the thing we will come to know, it will be in the black box. We can use pip list. That pip list will give us the complete installation so far now, whatever available with the Anaconda prompt or in your machine. That will not be helpful for us. Whenever we are working with Anaconda prompt itself only, we will come to know all the necessary dependencies. That is the reason whenever we are trying to deploy something, by the time we need to use. Now the question starts. I just start one small question. So just give me answer. For example, you are working on a data set, maybe sentiment analysis or the breast cancer data set or diabetic data set, Alzheimer data set, let it be anything. Very first question as a teacher, we used to inform to our student, which is the model works better for this data set, we will ask. Then naturally, what is the meaning? Every one of the person who is working with that data set needs to build as many as possible all the model. That is the reason data scientist role is felt that difficult. You need to do hyperparameter, you need to build all the model, you need to identify the best model suitable to the data set. Now the question is, which is the model you need to develop, you need to deploy? All the model you need to deploy or not is the question. Now I will look into chat window. I hope so you would understood the question. Take it any data set. You will be asking your student to develop, build the model, clean the data. Then you will be questioning which is the model works better for this data set. They may build one model or n model. That is different story. Finally, deployment, how we need to go for. For which model we need to go for, how we need to go for. For all the model we should go for or not is the question. You have built for the offline work activity, maybe 10 models, 12 models, whatever, whether it is a numerical prediction or it is a label prediction. So which portion or what you need to deploy out of that learning or out of that development of that project is the question. Anyone? All models, fine. Yeah, one answer I have received. Any more expressions or any more ideas you would like to share? At least one or two responses, around 50 members are there. So at least the ratio can become 1%. Hybrid model, that's fine. Yeah, that's fine, yeah. Now, offline, we can work with n number of model, whether hybrid model, ensemble model, or standalone model, or you are bringing different logic and combining with existing model, and or all other meta learning concept you are bringing, that all different story. In offline, we need to explore as much as possible the validity, the reliability, and giving new data sample. Only one sample we need to give, how it predicts. Testing is different and sample prediction is different. Testing is you will retain the original data itself 30%, 70%. That is testing. Whereas the prediction is we need to give one new data to the model. We need to artificially create for the all the possibilities. Worst possibility, best possibility, or all the possibilities. How it responds, how it produces the result. Based on that only, we need to take decision. After that, whichever the model performs with the highest accuracy, with a lesser loss, that all those things we need to fix in the offline, off the shelf. Once we need, we understood all the pros and cons, we need to fix the best model among the several models for the data set. That model alone we need to go and deploy. Hope so you would have understood. So you may develop 10 model, 12 model. Among the 12 model happen to have more or less same accuracy or same loss function. Both side we need to look at always, loss and accuracy. That best model or the optimized model we need to deploy. We need to take decision. However, both models are showing same accuracy nearby. We need to take decision based on different trials. We need to give different samples. How it produces the result for all the samples. Depending upon that, we need to go for all the validity check, all the reliability check. If it is done, only one model we need to deploy when it becomes business use case. That is a answer finally. Now, Flask, we need to go for web framework. We need to convert all our code, or we need to combine web framework or web coding. We need to enable web logic in our model building, in our Python core model building essentials. Into that, we need to bring something related to web development. Only then we can deploy. So for that, there are several frameworks available. Django framework. We can use JavaScript, simple JavaScript, or we can use PHP, or we can use Java, or we can use React.js, Node.js, Angular.js, or we can use anything, whichever you know, the .NET framework, then C#, whatever the web-related frameworks or languages available, we can use. I'm a such kind of web framework. One we are going to look at today is Flask. So that Flask web development, one drop at a time. So this is little bit easier, I can say, user friendly. How Heroku is user friendly for the deployment? Similarly, Flask is one of the user friendly framework for web development activity. Your core logic would become same. That is not going to be changed, but we need to bring web related constructor frameworks. So what is framework? Represents a collection of libraries and modules that enables a web application. That's all. So our code, whatever logistic regression, may be the best model you would have completed, or you would have completed decision tree as a best model. You would have got best accuracy for that data set with that model. So finally, we need to enable that code suitable to the web application. That is called web framework. One such web framework is Flask, so that it can able to interact with the protocol, internet protocol, HTTP protocol, all those protocol, thread management, threading concept you may be knowing. So the moment we hit that website, only one web logic. So everyone will have different access, several clients will be accessing with the different types of browsers, different types of requests. So every user access that web logic need to create a thread, so that every web application works in the philosophy called thread management only. So these all details, we no need to worry when we are relying on sophisticated web frameworks. Flask is one such a sophisticated. All the underneath details, that is called not low level, that is essential level, all micro level management, we no need to worry. All the superficial level coding, we need to learn and understand, we need to plug in. Automatically, it will be converted. Our coding is converted into web framework. Now we are going to look through our code also, then we will understand how it works. So this is called, this is also one of the institution project only. So Arvind, Ronachar, Python enthusiasts all together, international group they formed. So with that group, they have developed the project after several episodes of discussion. POCO project they have brought. That is based on, POCO project is based on WorkZug. It may be different, nothing to worry. It has two toolkit. So that toolkit they are giving to the public, like you and me. So we need to understand that the toolkit comments, that's all. So knowing that very few comments with the 5 to 6 steps, our own name-based classification, whatever the name-based classification used in this application is converted into web application. So that few steps of guidelines, it is available in these two, toolkit and template engine. One of the toolkit is WSGI toolkit. Another template engine is Jinja 2. So these are all the two stuff we are going to refer for ultimately to convert our machine learning code into web framework model. That's all. So now let us synthesize one by one. What is WSGI? Web Server Gateway Interface. So understand, now we are not bothered about gateway access, how gateway works, nothing we need to know. Just we need to superficially learn several steps. With that, we can immediately deploy. Deployment model is also very easier. That is cloud platform. We no need to understand how cloud is working. With the superficial steps, we can able to deploy. So this is specification for a universal interface between the web server and web application. That's all. So it will provide the access for web server and web application. For example, today we are going to look at the deployment model for mail classification, spam or not a spam. This is what web application. So your browser you can use after the deployment, you can access that project. So right now that project is on my machine. How I'm bringing to the web logic? Immediately, every one of you can experiment that. So that web server is what Heroku. Web application is what that spam classification. Who is accessor users? You will use different gadget, mobile or laptop or a tab. You will use different browser. It starts responding. So for that is called WSGI, Web Server Gateway Interface. Next, WorkZug. What is this? This WorkZug, what and all it does? I don't know spelling, it's pronunciation also. Whatever I feel so, I am pronouncing. You please refer. There is an exclusive website or YouTube channel is available only for pronunciation check. There, if you type this, then it will give the digitized voice. We can listen and we can learn. So request, response objects, and other utility functions. It will take care of a request, client request, response object. What are all the objects need to be communicated to each other? How ultimately I can say it is a computation, execution. Something need to be executed upon the given input. That all execution, utility functions, are all the processing, compilation, everything will happen. Finally, it needs to collect the result, need to be given back to the web request. So that is taken care by this. This enables building a web framework on top of it. So naturally, we no need to worry of how to place a request. If you write a small web application, you will come to know you need to mention the port, you need to mention the protocol, you need to mention the request, get request, post request, you need to mention all the response object, you need to mention all the instantiation, initialization, that all those things we need to take care. Now that all not required. We need to know only few steps, but we need to understand underneath what's all, what are happening. That's all. Next, this is Jinja 2 platform. What is this Jinja 2 platform? Or this is engine, template engine for Python. So this Jinja 2 is essential to install in our machine. If at all the same project we want to deploy into our own machine and we not to use local host for accessing. Before even deploying into Heroku, we need to do with the internal testing. After that only we need to launch with Heroku. That is a safer solution. Otherwise, it may not work with Heroku, but we are not permitted to diagnose and fix the bug and we cannot understand. So for that, we need to do first with our laptop. So that also, Jinja 2 template engine is required. What this templating does is, certain data source to render dynamic web pages. Finally, it allows for dynamic web page. You all know what is dynamic web page. The moment you enter something, the moment you click something, these all called dynamic web page. Static is what? They will put all the stuff in English. We need to go and read. We need to come back. That's all. Dynamic web page, Amazon web page, look at the moment we click the dress material, it will change that appearance, then basket, then select, then delete, then payment card. With the moment the web page is dynamically changing, depending upon the request and need of the user, it is termed as a dynamic web page. Now next is Flask is a micro framework, simple yet extensible. This is sufficient for our academic level of project or small kind of business related project also sufficient. What is a small business? I mean to say, your clients or request should not exceed more than 600 when it comes to Heroku. Flask, what is the capacity? I haven't seen actually while preparing material, that didn't strike. You can refer that. So within that 600 request at a time, within 100 milliseconds, 600 request, I mean to say. Within 100 milliseconds means within 2 minutes, more or less 2 minutes, 100 request comes to that web page, it withstands. If not, it won't work. Scalability will not suit. So beyond that, your customers, your business stakeholders or the public tend to access your stuff, then you should not go. What is, by the time only Amazon Web Services, Azure, Microsoft platform, Google platform, these all those stuff comes into the picture. It is a micro web framework. This is written in Python itself. It supports for Python as well. So that is a main thing. It is maintained by pre-existing third-party libraries. So we no need to worry. Only superficial level certain commands we need to know. If you want to come out with such kind of web or web framework you want to develop, then you need to go for all those details. Only for deployment or application perspective, we no need to look into this much code detail. That's all. So Flask framework is more explicit than Django. This is a popular framework supported by Python for the web development activity. Than Django framework, Flask is more easier, pretty much easier to deploy and run our work smoothly. That's all. So this is what I mean to give you a quick overview. Python, Flask, Tornado, Pramid, Pyramid, Django, Node.js, so many stuff available. So we can use any of the framework and we can develop our web application. Ultimately, you can say full stack architecture, front end, back end, all those interactions, web logic all together, full stack architecture. Now we move towards the project, how we can implement and we can do. Prerequisite Python, pip installation, Heroku, CLI. Next, GitHub. Git, these are all the prerequisites you need to do. Very first step, most of the deployment, not only for Heroku, pickling is a process, pickle is a process we need to take care. These all terminologies you can easily remember. There's something new to you, tricky or whatever, it makes you to remember easier. So what is this pickling is, completely you need to pack. You need to do serialization and marshalling. These are all the two tasks. What is the meaning? I mean, I can put it in simple form is all the dependencies. For example, you imagine a small C program. Main function we will write. Then in between we will do square root. Then you will write some user defined function. Then you will write some macro. What will happen is macro will be substituted in line. When the function call comes, it will be transferred to somewhere. Then internally stack maintenance will be created for the activation record. Then activation record creation, then accessing. Then when the return function is there, top of the stack is visited. So much mechanism will happen internally. Imagine web application, if sits and do this all, what will happen for us? So that all will be reduced. All the internal dependencies need to be packed and addressed before the request comes as a sequential flow of program, not a transferable flow of program. One by one, the flow of the execution should go. It should not get transferred from here and there, no jumping. So that kind of integration, compression or conversion is the process called pickling in simple terms. Imagine just a C program. Macro, whenever you are referring, macro call, macro invocation occurs, control will not be transferred. Macro need to be substituted in your inline. Whenever user-defined program comes, your user-defined function need to go and refer internal references. Whenever library references, like math.h, sqrt function if you are using, that goes external references. Those libraries would be available in your hard disk, then it needs to be brought into the memory and it needs to locate math.h is again a larger file. Then within that file where the sqrt is available, that portion, that modular component alone need to be referred. So these are all searching, again fixing, these all will happen. That all going to be avoided through the pickling process. Math.h, the entire thing will be kicked out. What is written for sqrt function? That portion alone brought here, no searching operation. Whenever we work on our machine, searching will happen with the math.h. Whenever we do string comparison, searching will happen with the string.h. So all those references and functionalities will take a lot of time, complication. So somebody gives a request, it sits and do. We will not rely on what will happen, whether we will get back the result. We do, especially recent days, we are not having any patients at all, no time at all. The moment I click it, at least partial information I want, that is when I feel confident, yes, this web page will be loaded. Nothing is responded, I don't bother, I close, I move on to next web page. So that this pickling process is essential. Hope so pickling you would have understood. So this is again the definitions I have brought, what is serialization. With this small story or this analogy, hope so you would be understanding. Similarly, Python also. We will bring NumPy, we will bring Pandas, or we will bring any other a larger package or library. Then we will use only one small function. So for that much memory space, we cannot put it in the web logic. It is costly affair. So we need to bring the relevant dependencies that need to be compressed or serialized, or it needs to be marshaled. So that all the packing together, all the necessary data structure creation, all the necessary dependencies linking, all the interlinking, this entire process together is called as pickling. Then only loading process is pending. That's all. So how to create a pickle file? All our program, first we need to create a pickle file. The project which I am showing, it will have two pickle files. One of the pickle file is related to the model training of the data set. One of the pickle file. Another pickle file is related to transformation. What is a transformation is the project which I am showing, demonstrating is meant for NLP, natural language processing. Because identifying the given mail message body, it belongs to spam or not a spam, is purely related to text information. Then the user starts giving, user means even after deploying, I will give you the link, you can experiment, no? By the time when you give, you will be the user for that web application. When you give, it will be the input to that app or application. So when your data goes, it is merely in the form of text. It needs to be converted into counter vectorizer. During NLP itself, I have given Amazon data review in the last HTTP. What is counter vectorizer? So that converts it into integer value, polarity value, or something like that. So that your data, user data, the moment I deploy and give the URL to you, you will become user of this app. No, then you give the data that needs to be transformed. So the transformation is done separately in a pickle file, because we need to identify all the different entities all in one pickle file. We cannot keep the training module is kept it in one pickle file, and the user, the moment they give the text information, that needs to be transformed into polarity information or counter vectorizer value. That is a key step, or statistical conversion, text statistical conversion. Only then with that numerical value, model can predict your type of message, whether which you have typed belongs to spam or not a spam. So for that, pickle file creation is essential. Depending upon your project, how many pickle file you want to create, it's all depending upon the context, depending upon the solution you provide, how many input you take, how many output you give, that all merely, and the logic, of course. So based on your context only, that can be decided. In this project, which I am going to demonstrate, have two pickle file. So how to create that pickle file? Because a deployment will accept only the pickle file. Please underline and note the point. We cannot give any other file extension, pickle extension. There are several extensions that also we are going to discuss. Just we need to have import to pickle. So this is the name of the package we need to have for pickling, or that creation, pickle file creation. So very first step, we are creating list data structure, a simple code only I'm showing, not the huge code. Then we need to give like this. So with open data file, we need to give the pickle file name. Here can be anything. I can give lakshmi.pkl also. I can give mobileapp.pkl, or I can give spam.pkl, or I can give cancerdata.pkl. That is our choice. So, but extension is mandatory. .pkl, comma, write mode. The file is opened in the write mode. This is alias name. If you wish, you can use, otherwise not required. As fh. Then pickle.dump my list, comma, fh. So after compression, after creation of all the internal dependencies, this only one small code is converted into pickle form. Similarly, here we need to give all our programming instances, that the entire instance need to be dumped. That also I'll work through. To start with, how to create a pickle file, a small coding I'm showing, the real code of this ML project, I'll show a little later. Now, pickle file extensions, .pickle, .pck, .pcl, .pkl, .db, these are all the type of extensions available I have taken from the internet. But in this project, I use only .pkl file, nothing more I use. Now, we need to come to know, although we say that pickling, the same process we can do with the pickling with the JSON also. JSON is a lightweight format. JSON format is most appreciating, data transmission format recent days than even XML. JSON is the best and well appreciated because of the nature called, it's a lightweight format, much faster than any other pickling process. Next, much more better. JSON is for common. Not only for machine learning or any other kind of web application, any other kind of product. When it comes machine learning and deep learning, TensorFlow.js, this is Google package. They offer a lot of free courses on TensorFlow.js. That is ultimate method of deploy. That is related to ML and DL. It is a serverless architecture. So you can explore this in near future, for if you want to provide services only on AL and DL, there are people looking for service providers for only the deployment opportunities also available. So you can take up that kind of opportunities in near future also if you become thorough enough. Now, these are all the packages we require to be installed for this project. Flask double equal to, we need to give in the Anaconda prompt, pip install immediately, not capital P, small p, pip install. This we need to copy. That's all. We need to sit and install. It had taken for Flask and one more thing, NLTK, and one more thing, Jinja. These three have taken bit more time. Yesterday started this by 8 o'clock only. This installation itself gone by 9. So this pip install Flask like this. That's all. Nothing more. Now you may ask question. Greater than symbol is available, double equal to available, hyphen is available, then capitalized letter is nothing to worry. Whatever I have given, just a copy paste or type. It will permit a copy paste. Anaconda prompt, you can copy paste. I will show that also. A small few steps installation, but it will tell requirement already satisfied. Let it be. Now, app.py. This is the final code file. This app.py we need to run. I will demonstrate both ways, executing in our machine, executing in the Heroku cloud deployment. So app.py, where in which the complete code is available, the same code I have copy pasted here, nothing more. From Flask, import Flask, render template, URL for request. So these all, see finally URL only we are going to give you now, these all required. Necessary requirement packages for web framework application. These are all the four we need to import. We are importing majorly Flask. We are working with Flask, we are importing. Since Flask is written in Python, it looks like Python only. You no need to worry of anything. Then import pandas. We need to read the data set, sub pandas. Import pickle for pickling process, PKL file creation. Sklearn feature extraction, text import, count vectorizer. This is where text information is converted into polarity information. From Sklearn, naive Bayes classification. This is what produces the best result, assuming that we are going to use, not a perfection at all I'm doing, one model deployment demonstration. So load the model from disk. So we need to load the model from the disk. So this file name equal to NLP underscore model PKL. Already pickle file is created. That how to create pickle file. Wait a minute. I'll show you here. See here where in which this all the hash portion is meant for pickle file creation. That all commented. So next, repeatedly we can't create pickle, no. Otherwise you want to replace this or no, that will ask, no. So that is freezed. Now we need to load two pickle file. NLP model pickle file name, trained model. Now we are going to open that file in the read mode. Similarly, we are going to open one more file, that is transform pickle. I said two pickle file in this project it is used. One of the pickle file is trained model. Another pickle file is for transforming the user data. For example, I need to, hi, how are you? Would you come to party tomorrow? If I ask no, that is the body of the mail, no. It needs to say it is spam or not. Rather, your credit card owned the price $1 billion. If I type no, that is a spam message. So your credit card, who bothers to give 1 crore? The person who given the credit card itself cannot give you 1 crore. So somebody is ready to give you 1 crore. So like that kind of spam will come. Your mobile have selected in the lottery for the price of $1 million. It will come, no? That all a mere spam. So that the spam, depending upon the message body, it text information need to be converted into count vectorizer. After that only, it can be processed and predicted. For that, the second logic is transform, the input transformation. So that transformation is available in another pickle file. I have kept the name transform. You wish you can keep anything, but pickle extension PKL is essential. Similarly, NLP model, even you can keep the name instead of NLP, naive-based model also you can keep. That choice is yours. Next, this is Flask initiator. For a main program, you will use a C program, main function you will use, no, initiator. Similarly, this Flask initiator, we need to use app equal to Flask of underscore, double underscore name, double underscore close. This is Flask initiator. Next is at app.root. Now we need to root directory it should go. Only then we can launch in our web browser for the internal operation, I mean to say. Next, same for web also. It needs to go to the root directory for all the home page, indexing, signifying, launching your page, that main page. For that, you need to give that root. Def home. Any website starts with web page or home page only. After that only, all other sub pages, all other web pages we will navigate. Return render underscore template home.html. Whatever you do, wherever you navigate, finally, the control should come back to the home page. That is the reason we are giving. Next, app at app route, open bracket slash predict dot methods equal to post. What is the thing is, there is a text box. The moment I launch the project, you will come to know text box. There only you need to type sample message. You need to type. You need to verify whether this model working properly or not. So that body message where you are typing, for that one template, the whatever you are typing, that message need to be posted to the web logic. There are two methods you can use for carrying the message from one application to another application. So that is get method, post method. The difference is get method will patch all the message with a URL. Any intruder can able to see your message, can able to hack or steal your information, or they will blackmail anything. You may send some sensitive message to your lover, then somebody will take that. Anything may happen. So that post method, what it will do is body of the message will be kept aside from the URL. So that message attack will become much lesser. Whereas I can say no need to attack also. The get method will be transparent. Whatever you are sending, it will be carried with the URL information altogether from one application to another application. So that is the reason post method. So it will collect your body message, what you are typing in that application. Now, these all for pickle file creation. Normal panda read CSV, spam.csv. I have the data also. Then encoding Latin 1. So next, df.drop. Unnamed columns are dropped. Unnecessary unwanted columns we are deleting. Features and labels. So df class, map, ham equal to 0, spam equal to 1. Ham is the word, not a spam. That's all. Spam is the word meant for spam, fishy mails or unwanted mails or dangerous mails. One. Next, we are converting it into x variable, y variable. All the dependent variable together, all independent variables are available in x. Only one dependent variable, that is label, prediction, spam or ham, is available with y. Now, feature extraction. Count vectorizer is initialized with a CV. CV dot fit to transform of X. All the available data set, trained data set, we are fitting into X. Next, now we are trying for dumping. This all the information related to CV, comma open transform dot pickle W write dumping. Now this alone, this count vectorizer alone, we have created one pickle file. Only one command, one pickle file. Now there is one more pickle file, CLF. This is another pickle file. That pickle file is NLP model. Look at the here, sklearn model selection, train test split. These are all normal. By this time, it should be like water in our mind. Then X train, Y train, four variable, train test split, 33% something. You can use 30% also. Then naive-based classifier. For that, this is a package required. Then CLF, multinomial naive-based we are bringing. We are initializing, object initialization we are doing for the naive-based classification. Next, fit X train, Y train, score, X test, Y test. Finally, we are finding the score. Now come here, file name, pickle file creation, NLP underscore model dot pickle. That is the file name we want to keep. If you want, you can keep any name. Now pickle dot dump, CLF, what we want to create. CLF information, all the information until this, whatever associated with the CLF, all those stuff, that is almost I can say configuration information or weight information or train the model parameter information, that all dumped into pickle file. That's it. Pickle file creation over for this project. Now if request method equal to post, that is a method. So this is useful for message fetch. Already we have requested post method. Now really we are collecting, harvesting the message text by the user into message. That message is given to data. That data is sent for the transform pickle file for the counter vectorizer. Then we are sending for the predict, clf.predict, my prediction. Then with that my prediction, it returns render template. I will show you one gray color style should be there, no, some color under text box you need to type, no, that need to be created, no, and one button for submission, that all together render template. Next, if underscore underscore name underscore equal to main function for Python, app dot run, it will start initiating the starting of the app. That's all. So you will be doing 20 model, 30 model, you need to finalize, freeze one model. That model you can go about for the deployment. This is what, and the difference between get method, post method, you can subsequently read it. This is meant for hypertext transfer protocol across the web. So across the web, the famous methods are get and post. Now let us see how to fix the model. Finally, you will develop 10 model, 20 model, no? Finally, how to fix? For that, a small clue I want to give, then I will move on to the hands-on. No relationship between two matrices. That is accuracy and loss, no relationship. Please understand. Low accuracy, low loss, high accuracy. That is a mantra, but there is no interrelationship. 99% accuracy if you get, it doesn't mean that loss should become only 1%. Please understand. This misconception we should not carry forward after 4 weeks of session. That is the reason I'm concluding today now. Now, a low accuracy and a huge loss means that you made huge errors on a lot of data. Low accuracy, that is a useless case. Low accuracy, huge error, who bothers? Low accuracy, but low loss means little error on lot of data. Understand. Great accuracy with a low loss means you made low error on a few data, very few rows of data or into loss of fit. So that is best case. Great accuracy, but a huge loss, that signifies huge error on a few data only, but the error is too huge. Maybe outlier I can say, or odd out of crowd I can say. So this is the four possibilities can exist between the relationship error and accuracy and a loss. So that interpretation we should have very clear crystal. So that is the way we can take decision, which model is best, how we can take it forward, move forward. Now, finally, loss is subjective matter. It is dependent upon the problem. So point two only, no, my loss, let it be. We can't tell. If it is medical application, that is also not appreciated. For that, I have given a case here. If it is cancer prediction, cancer detection, then point one error itself is a huge. So it is context dependent. So that amount and the quantification of that error is context dependent, that nobody can address, I cannot address. So that's all. Now, few advices, few tips I want to give. Normally at the end concluding session, I will be giving some takeaways. Similarly, I want to give you a takeaway today. So this is the LinkedIn. This is deeplearning.ai. That is Stanford University. Stanford University professor and his team creating and running this LinkedIn forum. They have plenty of most appreciating courses in the Coursera. Coursera in our institution, they made free. They have gone for bulk registration. I am doing a lot of Coursera courses. For me, it is free. My management given me free. For you, I don't know what is the way. L4G, they have got tied up. So that expiry is going to become end of November. So that, but most of the stuff freely available. So please request into this. You will learn a lot of stuff with the renowned professors. Then next is MLDL. I am going to create one group. So if you wish, you can join with that group. I'm the admin, I'm the moderator. So only one thumb rule, two thumb rules. One is, other than machine learning, deep learning related stuff, nothing else should be in that group. Otherwise, immediately I will make them to, I will remove them. Anything you can post, maybe any workshop detail or any of your question, or you can appreciating material, you do whatever, but that is related to MLDL. You can bring cartoon related to MLDL, anything centric to MLDL, I welcome to post in that group. Next condition, the moment to be part of that group, collective learning, I want to bring the concept called collective learning. So every one of the team member need to give a short presentation when the schedule is planned. Whatever you know, you can come and give presentation. But attending somebody's presentation is your choice. You can attend, you no need to attend. So I will schedule the link, I will schedule the timing, I will schedule the timing or the all other details. So the moment I will post a list of topics, anyone can pick any topic. Anyone can pick a multiple, the same topic, multiple persons, but the stuff or the project or the way of explanation, something will differ. So need to give a presentation. These are all the two thumb rules. If you wish with these two thumb rules, I most welcome you to be part of this WhatsApp group. So this is anyone, your students, your friends, yourself, anyone can be part of this group, but should be a contributor. That is the main highlight I want to give here. If you are really a contributor to the group, let us all be gratitude to each other. Let us learn together. Let us grow together. Let us cherish our accomplishment towards the domain MLDL. First, we start slowly MLDL, then interdisciplinary, then multidisciplinary. What is interdisciplinary? Combining two different concepts like big data and machine learning, deep learning and big data. And the IoT, machine learning, agriculture domain, machine learning, deep learning, like first interdisciplinary approaches, blockchain with artificial intelligence, cybersecurity with artificial intelligence, first understanding DLML thoroughly for some months, couple of months. Subsequently, I am having the vision of taking it forward for the interdisciplinary activities. Then I am having the vision of taking it forward that group towards multidisciplinary activities. How AI is helpful for physics, how AI is helpful for mathematics, how AI is helpful for chemistry, anything that is multidisciplinary. So this is the periodical upgradation I wanted to do with this team. Serious guys only I am expecting. No nuisance people. I am strictly going to follow this. Only contributor. You learn little also, fine. You come and contribute. Let us be gratitude to each other. Let us learn for free of cost. Why I am creating this kind of opportunities? Any AIML, very costly affair. quality if you want, minimum you need to spend from your pocket 60,000, 1,50,000. If there is no quality, you will get for the cheap rate of 3,000 to 10,000 rupees of courses. Choice is yours. So we need to grow ourselves within ourselves. So one person sitting and learning everything will be tedious. See, when every week I will be hosting 3 to 5 sessions minimum every week in and around Hyderabad. So I am daily spending 1 o'clock till 1 o'clock. Every day I am sleeping by 1 o'clock. It is very tedious process. Just for this being a resource person itself, I am working a lot. But if I want to learn everything, very tough. One man cannot learn everything. Definitely, individual mind cannot become great. I can assure. Maybe born intelligence, that is gifted people. Gifted people can do a lot of breakthrough, but not all of us. So if we want to be like a great genius, collective thought only is possible. Right now, I'm sharing in the chat window, WhatsApp link alone. In this file itself, I will send, I will dispatch. You can join. Now, next is, this is one of the best article. It will take minimum, I'm telling, 10 hours to 20 hours to understand and digest this stuff. Explainable AI. The best material which I have come across for explainable AI is this. Please spend some time in understanding, executing that code, experiencing. This is subsequent exercise for all of you. Food for thought. Next, I am happy to share about around 20 to 25 projects. Curated CoLab notebook. It works well, perfect. So that is the meaning called curated. Not even single bug available. If at all bug we are having, then it is our problem. We are not understanding the guidelines to execute. That is the meaning of curated, vision related projects. Then there is a book for machine learning in Python. So this book is much more sufficient to learn anyone to start with. Similarly, this is the book, Deep Learning with Python. So a lot of book available, theory separate book, coding separate book, like that people will give. These are all the book all in one package. These all available right now in my Google Drive. It is, I have given the access for anyone, not even the participant, anyone you share, they can all download these 3 stuff. So these 3 are the documents I'm giving as a takeaway. Then this is the YouTube channel, rest all the comments. So whichever the command, if you want to work during the installation, that all I have put in this document. Let us move on to the execution. Screen, you please acknowledge, any one of you. Right now I am showing my folder. Is it visible? Local disk, my computer I am showing. Yeah, thank you. Now, these are all the stuff available in this project. So what and all available, let us see. App, this is the name of the main file. I use app, if you wish, you can. Which one you are asking, sir? Paramashivam, sir? Share once again, I what I need to share, my screen or WhatsApp link? WhatsApp link means this. Yeah, then one pickle file, that is the pre-trained model or trained model. Next is prop file. This prop file is important for this complete project requirements. This is where it is a simple text file. All the requirements and required for this project for the deployment time we need to mention in it. Then spam, this is the original data set. Then transform.pickle, another pickle file. These are all necessary stuff we need to have. This template we need to have for UI. Yeah, drive link, that word file I will give you. No, wait a minute. I will give you this word file, sir. Coordinator will be sharing with you. Fine. Okay. Now let us see one by one. I'm going to open Anaconda command prompt. I'll close once again. Could you see Anaconda prompt, please, one more time? Black color window. Anaconda prompt.
Yes, ma'am.
Any one of you, please acknowledge me quickly. Already 3:15. Yeah. 3:15 she asked to complete. Now we reached. Now what we need to do, we need to change the directory to this project folder. You can keep anywhere. No condition that you need to keep this particular location. D drive, C drive, any drive you can keep. I'm just copying the path of that project. I will be sending you one folder. You need to extract that folder, RAR folder. Same way only you need to do. But you need to install all those things. Pip install, Jinja. These all you need to include. See, I'm just giving CD, the entire path. Sorry, I didn't give. Yeah, it is available. CD space entire path. Change it to that project folder path. Now, pip install. There is one file I have shown, requirements.txt. So that minus R I need to give, hyphen R I need to give, requirements.txt. I need to give the complete file. Perfectly, I need to give. Enter. It executes. Once if this is done, we are back with the command prompt. Now we need to give Python. The name of the file is app.py. I need to compile that file, app.py. Python space app.py. These are all the two steps. Now it will give, it will do the starting, running. It gives me, look at here, it gives me the URL. Automatically it gives the URL. http:// This is for local browser execution. Now I'm going to open the browser. Hope so browser you all could able to see visible. Entry. That's all. This is the template. Spam detector for email message. Enter your body. Welcome you all to the last day session. This is a message I'm giving. Predict. Not a spam. Ham. It is not a spam, no. Now, I need to click the back. After back button, I'm going to give your credit card won the prize. I'm giving predict spam. That's all. So this post method is collecting the message which I am typing. Now I cannot make you to demonstrate with this project. I need to deploy in the Heroku platform. After that only you or me can access. Now it is on my machine. For me only it is possible to work on this project. But we need to work on our browser. It should work stable. Only then we can step into Heroku. That is why I'm doing this demonstration. Now this is over. Next, we are with the Heroku platform, GitHub. This GitHub account is also my student account, Manidev. So he have deposited everything here, NLP project. So this NLP project, if you click, these all the files, whatever you have seen the same, template, proc file, app.py, NLP model, requirements, spam.csv, the original data, transform.pickle file. These all available. Now we need to go to Heroku. We need to create one account. Now, after creating this account, what I need to do? Create an app. 1 minute. Something will change your settings. Yeah, this is what your homepage after creating account. So after creating account, if you look at these all, the stuff already demonstrated or deployed. These all are available. Image production, these all are. Now I will show you the present demo so that this will also become gallery with this all. Now what we supposed to do is, if you look at on the top right corner, new, click new button. So we are creating new app now. So I need to create new button naturally. It will ask you to two options. Create new app, create new pipeline. Pipeline is for multiple instances creation, something like that. So we don't want, we want to create one simple app now. So create new app. So click new app. After clicking new app, what you need to do is app name. 1 minute. Create app. That region, UK, whatever, let it be. No need to worry. After that, that create app, we need to click. Only simple step, click option only. It's like a kid project. GitHub, click this GitHub. After clicking GitHub, we need to search that GitHub, the project named is with the NLP title. The name of the GitHub is associated, linked already with the Manideep, so that I'm using NLP project. The whichever the project has the keyword NLP, that is brought here. Connect, click connect. Simple steps. Flask only you need to learn. Hero ko nothing to learn, only click, 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 click. Even your kids can deploy a project. Now, deploy branch. We need to click deploy branch. Last step. If you look at, see, it is building. It is bringing all the necessary installation. So it a wheel file. Most of the project require wheel file. That the wheel file installation, SQLite 3, requirements file, whatever we have mentioned in our requirement file, no, everything it is installation, installing. So after this all installation, it will tell successfully installed. After that, we need to view project. That's all. Heroku is a very simplest platform to deploy for the academic project, especially I can say. No such platform is this much easier. Still, it is executing. It may take another 5-10 minutes for this demonstration. It should give the word, see, compressing, pickle file compression, this all happening now. If you look at read here, compressing, NLTK, corpus collection, NLTK has huge corpus. Corpus means words. Our brain learns language with corpus only. So it should tell that completion. Today it's taking a lot of time. I don't know. Yeah. See, look at your app was successfully installed. This area. Until then, we need to wait quietly. So now I need to click view. My app is deployed. Now you also can see my app, how it is working. See, I'll give this link. Now every one of you, welcome to this app. I forgot to give one name. Actually, I need to give a name, SRM, that something it had taken default. I didn't give the name. Yeah. Now you also can access this. Sorry, I forgot to give one name. UK it is asking, no, there I need to give a name. That name should be permitted. If I didn't, I didn't give name, automatically it had taken. That is one mistake I did. If you wish, I can do once again the demo. You can type like that earlier. Goodbye, predict, not a spam, and click this. You won the prize for your lottery. These are all the spam mail, predict, spam. So like this, you also can do demo. So this is called deployment. It is in the web platform. So you also can access. I'm the owner of this app. I also can access. You are just an end user. You also can access. That is the meaning called deployment. Now that entire coding through Flask web framework, we have deployed to the EC platform called Heroku. Heroku is not at all helpful for us. It's only for deploying our project. That a few steps we should know. Pickle file, proc file, these are all the steps. Proc file creation, pickle file creation, that should become successful. Requirement gathering information, these all should be very careful. Which version we need to give, that is a little bit tough only, not so easy and all. That all information we need to freeze and put it in the GitHub repository. That GitHub repository we are uploading to this, then we need to send it. Yeah, we need to send it. So this is called web deployment. Flask is the best web framework for Python. So if you wish the highest performing platform, TensorFlow.js. So that is the ultimate global standard. If you want to raise yourself, you need to go for TensorFlow.js. But it is a good beginning. we the academician, we do lot of stuff, but we will be not able to sell our skill, commercial skills, because we are not in the position to deploy how to do. Then we will be scary of that. We'll do modeling and research and all, but we cannot deploy. So it end process, that is the reason in the HTTP 3 DB creation also brought in this workshop. This is not as academician. It will balance to you to take a metamorphism of a entrepreneur or a freelancer or industrialist or the academician. Now choice is yours. You can become academician or industrialist. So that entire walkthrough of this workshop, you would have noticed, well balanced for you both. So with that note, almost I'm concluding. If you have any questions, you are welcome. Already almost we bit delayed. We supposed to complete by by 3:10, around 3:10. Now it is almost 3:40. Let it be, because the time can be extended. It's all in our control. I request Supraja madam to give more time for the submission of the MCQs. You can
yes ma'am, I will open it by 4:00 also, no problem. I will give good time, enough time for that. Thank you so much madam for that. Participants, I have shared the attendance link. Overall feedback link has been shared in the morning. If anybody didn't submitted the overall feedback form, once again I am sharing that overall feedback form. Please fill that form also. It's mandatory to fill overall feedback form as well as, so I'm just mentioning overall feedback form.
That is also ready. If you wish anything to be asked, you can proceed forward.
Anybody wants to give any feedback about this STP, because we have completed 4 STPs, so any audience can give your feedback to us. It will be really grateful for us. Audience, anybody wants to say about a feedback from your side?
Yeah, good afternoon, ma'am.
Yes, sir. Please, sir.
Yeah, Professor Krishnanand here from Bangalore.
Oh, thank you, sir. Yes, sir.
A very nice, excellent organized workshop, ma'am. Especially thank Lakshmi, you. Ma'am, I think you are too good in explaining anything. I don't know how come you are so good, really. it's amazing to see that you can explain everything so easily that we are able to capture it, even though, like, especially NLP, RN and all, very new to us. We are not really aware of all these things properly to use also. But you make it little easy for us to at least grasp the things. That's good, ma'am. Really good.
Almost in all the STTP, I have brought, I introduced Supraja madam, my friends. So most of the resource persons.
She has taken very good,
yeah.
I think.
She accepted.
The,
yeah.
Resource persons properly. So I think that Jackson sir and many other people.
Yes.
Madam, I was telling good friends. So an excellent workshop, ma'am.
STTP
4 I really like compared to STTP 3. I didn't attend 1 and 2.
Okay.
I didn't know about it. But this 4 one was really good, ma'am. Really, the 4th one was really good. Like icing on the cake.
Thank you.
I think Supraja ma'am and the team of SRM should really take credit for this. So the principal or somebody is there, I will really tell them that Supraja ma'am has done a real good job.
Oh my God. Thank you.
Organizing all these things, especially bringing that these kind of resource persons is quite commendable, really quite commendable.
They have given a complete control to us. So that is a very big thing about SRM, because SRM always believe. Thank you so much for.
Actually, Supraja madam, after receiving the fund, she started sharing with me. Finally, I need to empower at least a couple of teachers ready to the business or ready to the research. That is my motto and ambition. For that suitability, I want resource persons. So that is what she had put the very first conversation. So it is not for a kind of conducting session. Finally, benefit, at least 20% benefit people are taking, that would be great. Like that, she said. So that vision makes to become true, I guess. That's it.
Thank you so much.
Good afternoon, ma'am.
Yes, sir.
Myself, Kunal Bursi from Guru Gobind Singh Polytechnic, Nasik. So
yes,
I was completely new to the subject, not witness to the earlier 3 phases, earlier 1-3. But I definitely can say that, yes, there is a little bit, you can say that introduction at a beginner phase to this. And what was the speakers were there are having the expertise and certainly yes, came across this such a STDP was very helpful. It's a nice and best wishes to all the organizing team, including the Supraja ma'am and
thank you so much, sir. Thank
organizing
you.
Committee, SRM Institute. Thank you very much. Thank it was you, very sir. Nice experience.
Thank you, sir. It's a very happy to hear from you, all of you.
Good evening.
Thank you so much. Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Good evening, madam.
Yes. And, yes, sir.
First of all, I congratulate to Supraja madam to plan out such type of HTTP from phase 1 to phase 4. I have attended all the 4 phases of HTTP.
That's great. How patient you need for attending all 4. Yes. Thank you so much.
Yes, ma'am. It's help for my research work at least 40 to 50%. And Lakshmi madam's sessions are very well and excellent. All the speakers who are be for phase 1 to phase 4, you have selected or choose, that is the right choice, madam. And it's a completely big advantage for me, especially because I have difficult with related to some concept, but it should be very clarified from HTTP 1, phase 1 to phase 4. I thank to your entire team, madam. Supraja madam,
you,
and
your
thank team.
You, thank
is very,
you so much.
Well manner organizing with every part. So thank you once again, madam. In future also, if you conduct, then we will all get benefit with related
thank
to
you.
Research
thank
and
you,
the
sir.
Concept. Madam.
Thank you.
Thank you,
sir. Thank you so much, all the participants. I'll just give a thank you note. Before sharing a quiz link, I just give a thank you note and I'll share the quiz link and you can submit all your quiz. Now it's like around 4 o'clock. So I think we can close the quiz link by 5 o'clock today evening. Thank you for joining our AICT sponsor, SRM STDP on Machine Learning with Python and the Data Science Application and Research Perspective. I take this opportunity to thank all the people who made to bring this event alive. First of all, I thank all of our resource persons, Dr. Lakshmi ma'am, Dr. Lavlin Rose ma'am, Dr. Kartika Krenuka ma'am, Rijo Jackson Tom, Siranjeevi sir, Srinivas sir, Sunit Gupta sir, Srikant sir, for excellent delivery of a series of lectures on various topics on machine learning and data science. They were actually given a very crystal clear idea on each and every topic, irrespective to the theoretical and practical. They have never compromised on the quality while delivering their sessions. Thank you so much. All the resource person. Not only this phase, in the phase 1, 2, 3, we have got such a nice resource person, such a nice team to work with. Thank you so much. It's a time to thank all our chief patrons of SRM IST. So our institute is very good at encouraging young researchers and very support to organize these kind of events. I would like to thank our founder chancellor, Parivendra sir, pro-chancellor Satya Narayanan sir and Ravi Pachamuthu sir, and vice chancellor Sandeep Sanchetti, Registrar Sedharaman sir, pro-vice chancellor Dr. Mittamil Chanman sir, Dean CET Dr. T.V. Gopal sir, Chairperson of School of Computing, Dr. Revati Venkatraman, and our beloved elder of the department, Dr. Vadivu ma'am, for their constant support and encouragement that they always ensure that we always do the right things and in the right way. And we are fortunate enough to back up with a team of faculty members running all around to bring this event alive. So I would like to thank my team members, Dr. Gayatri, Ellen Victoria, Divya, Sai Sandhya, Ranjini, Vijay Lakshmi, for the timely support and managing this event when I was not there. So we have conducted this AICT in 4 phased manner, and we have covered a complete package of all the required topics right from the basic to advanced. So which we believe it will be great to begin to work on challenging research projects. So I would like to thank all our participants. You are such a nice team to work with, very active, very cooperative throughout our HTTP. I personally got many contacts and a very good person to collaborate with for in project view and various activities. I'm looking forward for all your support, even for all the future collaborations, as well as we are all working in the same field. So on behalf of SRM IST, I thank you all for being with us in this STDP journey. Thank you so much. This quiz link I will share now. This quiz link I will share both in the YouTube and Zoom link. Once your link is submitted, possibly by approval we will get by tomorrow from head of the department. So Friday you will be receiving your certificates. And those who have attended phase 1, 2, 3, 4, I have taken the list, and you are also dropped your email ID personally. We will give you a certificate of appreciation for attending all the 4 STTP. So I've just posted the quiz link in the chat. Please, you can start taking your quiz. All the very best. Wish you all a very bright future. Wish you all a very happy Diwali.
Yeah. Thank you all. Wish you all success. Let us get connected in any one or other platform. Wish you all success. Thank you, Supraja ma'am.
Thank you.
Wish you all happy Diwali.
Thank you.
Happy Diwali, Lakshmi ma'am.
Thank you, sir. Wish you all. Thank you, Diwali. Yeah.
Thank you, everyone. Thank you for being with us in this STP journey. Thank you. I have shared the quiz link. You can all start working on the quiz. I will stop this quiz short by 5 o'clock. Thank you so much. It's there in the YouTube also. You can check the quiz link in the YouTube. Thank you.